Okay, so can you see the screen now? Hello?
No, sir.
दिखाई दे रहा है स्क्रीन? स्क्रीन दिखाई दे रहा है?
नहीं सर।
यस सर।
Now, can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today we are going to discuss on a new topic. Not a new, though we already introduced this topic in the last class. Still, we have to cover this particular topic in greater detail because this topic is also enlisted in our syllabus, which is very important for our exam as well. So in group discussion, we will focus on the organizational ID, right? So, in the organizational ID, so we will see. What is organizational GD? Sorry, GD stands for group discussion. Okay, now what is organizational GD? Organizational group discussion. It means group discussion in workplaces, group discussion in organizations. Okay, now in organizations, GDs. Group discussions are chiefly used for group decision making. Okay, so group discussion are chiefly used for group decision making. To make the decisions, group discussions are very important. Otherwise, if an individual makes the decision on his or her own choice, then that decision may not be similar, may not be same to other workers. Okay, so for that, group discussion meetings are very much important for decision making. Right. Now the next point is members of the interacting group take the responsibility of explaining their ideas and arriving at a consensus. Consensus means where all the people are of the same opinion. Okay. So in the group discussion meeting, there will be members and they will interact. Okay, and because they take the responsibility to explain their ideas, and through that process they will try to arrive at a decision. They will try to arrive at a particular decision for all. Right. Okay, so this was the basic idea of organizational GD or group discussion. There will be a meeting, and that meeting will be formed in terms of group discussion, and in that group discussion meetings there will be selected numbers and they will discuss upon a topic to reach or to arrive at a particular decision, which decision will be applicable for all the members. That is a kind of group discussion in organization or organizational GD, as we say. Now, what are the techniques through which we can conduct group discussions? So there are many techniques, but among many techniques, we have three major techniques of group discussions, and these techniques are very important. Any of these three techniques will come in the exam. You have to answer to these questions, that what is brainstorming and all. Okay, we will discuss one by one. So in the first technique, brainstorming, you may have heard this word before. Brainstorming, you know, when you think about many ideas, and when those ideas becomes intense, deep study, sometimes it becomes complex, sometimes becomes very problematic. Okay, so that is a kind of storming your brain, because you are trying to understand something which cannot be understood easily, but you are working rigorously to understand it. So that rigorous process can be called as brainstorming. Okay, we say brainstorming thoughts. Now, what is brainstorming technique in organizational GD, in organizational group discussion? Now, this is very important, what I am going to read out now, that brainstorming is a method for generating a variety of ideas and perspectives. Okay, it is a method which generates many ideas, many perspectives. It is as uncritical as possible, because criticism inhibits the free flow of ideas. Okay, so it is very free, it is very much uncritical. Okay, so you can enjoy to say anything, you can have the free flow of ideas, whatever ideas that are churning in your mind, you can share them with the members, you can share those ideas with the members. Okay, you don't have to worry about that the ideas that I am thinking in my head is not established, so I should not speak it out. But in brainstorming technique, you will get the liberty to speak it out, those ideas which are yet to be established, and you consider them still very, very important. You can share those ideas with the members who will be present in that organizational group discussion, right? So first point is that it gives a scope for the variety of ideas and perspectives. It gives you the power to criticize, the power to analyze. You can share your views. Those views may sound off the track, off the beat, but still you can show the justification of those ideas. If you can justify what you say, then definitely that will be, you know, considered as important in organizational group discussion. Okay, so next point is brainstorming thoughts are very much important in higher studies, especially for project works, for MPhil projects, for PhD dissertations, postdoc. So many higher studies branches are there where brainstorming thoughts are very important. In especially some of the, not all, some of the seminars, webinars, conferences definitely conduct brainstorming sessions. That only happens by the speaker actually. Anyway, next point. The people involved in brainstorming should ideally come from a wide range of disciplines. Aisa nahi hai ki if you want to participate in this group discussion, then you should belong to science, or you should belong to arts, or you should belong to management department. No, it has an interdisciplinary approach. Okay, So it can involve arts, science, management, or many other branches. Okay? So the people involved in brainstorming should ideally come from a wide range of disciplines. It should be interdisciplinary. It should be even cross-disciplinary. It can cross the disciplines one to other. Okay. And have divergent social and cultural backgrounds. Your cultural background can be different, my cultural background can be different, others' cultural background can be different. So differences can be there, no issue at all about that. Okay. Next is the more diverse the group, the more likely it is to generate unexpected insights. Okay. If you can justify that I have that you have this knowledge, you have thought about like this, you have thought about this particular issue in this manner, though that analysis sounds very off the track, sounds very unacademic, still, if you can justify definitely that unexpected insights or unexpected ideas can be considered important. Okay, so brainstorming technique is very wide. It has enough scope. You can say it always ends with open interpretation. It never ends with close. Just a minute, just a minute. हेलो, आवाज आ रही है? हेलो,
यस सर।
ओके ओके। अच्छा, समझ में आ रहा है ना?
यस सर।
ओके, ठीक है। सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू। सो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दैट द ग्रुप कैन बी डाइवर्स, पार्टिसिपेंट्स कैन बी डाइवर्स, दे कैन बिलोंग टू डाइवर्स कल्चर्स, दे कैन बिलोंग टू डाइवर्स बैकग्राउंड्स, they can belong to diverse disciplines and still they can participate actively, attentively, and share their brainstorming thoughts, their brainstorming insights. Okay, those insights, those ideas, those beliefs, those analysis may sound very much unacademic, very much illogical maybe to some of the persons, but if you can justify, then definitely those insights, those unexpected views can be considered as valid and important and can be useful for further understandings. Okay, so these are some of the important points. Now let's have a different look of brainstorming technique in organizational GD. So, as you see that in the screen, that a typical brainstorming session follows the steps. There are some steps through which you can conduct the organizational GD in brainstorming technique. So, one step can be like you first of all think about a group, and that group must consist of 6 to 12 persons who will sit around a table. Okay, this is the technique. These are the technical elements that we need to keep in mind while conducting brainstorming technique in organizational GD. There are many techniques, isn't it? Maybe there will be one leader and he will keep on saying and saying and saying and saying, and other members will listen silently, and the meeting will end. So this is also kind of technique. Okay, we will move on to that technique later, but this technique is very important among the others. So first of all, there will be a group, and that group must contend with 6 to 12 persons who will sit around a table, right? Next step is the group leader states the problem in a clear manner. There will be a leader. There will be yes, there will be the head of the meeting, and who will state the problem in a clear manner so that all participants must understand it. Okay, next, those members actually suggest as many alternatives. Okay, so if there are six persons, so definitely six different views can be expected, right? Members suggest as many alternatives as they can in a given length of time. You have to take care of the time budget of time, right? You have to budget the time. You cannot extend the budget of time. You have to take care of the time constraint. Okay, so within the budgeting of the time, within the length of time, you have to suggest your alternative views to the issue, to the main issue. Okay, so members suggest as many alternatives as they can in a given length of time and write down on a blackboard or whiteboard or flip chart or a piece of paper. So in this particular case, when those people will sit around a table, so definitely they will have a piece of paper and they will write down their alternative views, and when they will get their own turn, they will stand up and speak out their alternative views. Clear? Okay, so while the head will state the problem, you must think about it, listen to him or her, then immediately write down whatever thoughts are you have in your mind regarding that specific topic, and when the turn will come to you, definitely you should share your alternative views to that. This is how if there are six people, then six people will give their views. If there are eight people, then eight people will give their views, and this is how they will try to reach at a particular conclusion. Next step can be, no criticism is allowed and all the alternatives are recorded for later discussion and analysis. Okay, there is no criticism is not allowed actually. Here, criticism in a biased sense, okay, in a partial sense. Criticism should not be entertained. If you want to criticize, then you have to show the data, you have to show the evidence. To authenticate your criticism needs to be attached with a certification of data, certification of evidence. Only then you can criticize. You cannot criticize saying many things in the air. You have to validate it. You have to authenticate it with evidence. Okay. Now, so that was the steps of brainstorming technique. Now the types of brainstorming technique. There are two types of brainstorming. One is storyboarding brainstorming technique, another is lotus blossom brainstorming technique. Now let's look at the first brainstorming technique, that is storyboarding. What is storyboarding? Does it make any sense? No. Let's make sense then. Storyboarding brainstorming technique. Storyboarding means, you know, in storyboarding, participants identify major issues and brainstorm on each of them. So participants will identify the major issues. Okay, they will first identify the major issues and brainstorm on each of them. Brainstorm in a simple sense is discuss in a greater detail. That is called brainstorming. Discussion in a very deep, in depth and greater detail. So participants will first of all will identify the major problem, and then they will, you know,